Hello friends, this is Supriya Mogle. I'm working as an assistant professor at Center for Distance Education, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. I'm here to discuss about Asian Development Bank, which is one of the important part of international business. So first we'll see the introduction. Asian Development Bank is a regional development bank established on 19th December 1966 to promote social and economic development in Asia. So this is the regional development bank formed for social and economic development only for Asian Pacific region. Okay, it is headquartered in Ortigas Center, which is located in Philippines. So there are a total 68 members now. Earlier when it was established, the members were 31, but now it is 68, okay? And out of which 49 members are from Asia Pacific region, where India is also included, and other 19 out of 68 are from other countries, okay? But the question arises here, if this is for only Asia's Pacific countries, then why other 19 countries are included as a member? As it promotes social economic development of Asia Pacific region, it needs capital. So to raise the capital for development, other countries are included where all the members contribute their fund. Okay. It functions same as World Bank, like poverty elimination, but only for Asian Pacific region. The next point is functions of Asian Development Bank. First is provides loan for social development and economic development. Obviously, it is formed and it is established for social and economic development, so it provides loans to that region. Provides technical assistance for planning and execution of the development. If suppose any country needs some technical assistance, then ADB is going to provide. Then third is promotes and facilitates investments of public and private capital for development. The next is organizational structure of ADB. Okay, so in the organizational structure, first comes board of governance, where one governor and one alternate governor is elected from each member country. Okay, for now there are 68 members, so for 68 members, one governor plus one alternate governor. Okay, that means 68 into 2, total numbers is 136. That means in the board of governance of ADE, there are total 136 members. From India, there are two governors. The main governor is Nirmala Sitharaman, and the second alternate governor is Atanu Chakraborty. Okay, then board of directors. There are total 12 members in the board of directors, and board of governors are appointed this board of directors. Then it comes to bank president. Okay, he is a chairperson appointed as per the highest voting power of the country. So he will be the chairperson and who will appoint as per their voting power. So what is voting power? We'll see in the next slide. So what are the voting rights? Okay, how the president of ADB or the chairperson of this bank is elected? It depends on the voting power of a country. That means a country which contributes highest capital or highest fund, it will get highest voting power. And if a country gets highest voting power, they will vote for their country. The interesting thing is, from the date of establishment, a president is elected for every year is from Japan, because Japan is contributing the highest capital. Okay, so right now, according to 17th January 2020, Masatsugu Asawaka is the president of Asian Development Bank. Okay, so how much they contribute? Japan contributes 12.84%, which is highest. USA contributes 12.75%, and India contributes 5.38%. Clear? The next is the bank's operations cover following sectors. So in the economic and social development, which sectors are focused? So the first is agriculture and natural resources, transport, communication, energy, industry and non-fuel minerals, finance and social infrastructure. So these are the sectors which are focused for social and economic development in the Asia Pacific region. Okay. So here I complete my video. I hope you understood the concept of Asian Development Bank. Thank you.